Bringing people and communities together on seclosounds.org.
Morning and welcome to NK Business Brunch with me, David Tooley, on Seclose Sounds, community radio for Milton Keynes. Let's make this the most profitable way to spend the next hour. Got some great guests in the studio this morning. Studio is packed with people from MK Academy, Interdirect and Screenetics, Kevin Hollick, Nicholas Mann and Debbie Glockelen, and JY Sharif as well. So let's, before we get the show going proper, I'll play your tune. Allows me to sort a few bits and pieces out and make sure I'm ready for the rest of the show. And this is Rhythm Is Gonna Get Ya by Gloria Estefan.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning, good morning. You're listening to MK Business Brunch with me, David Tooley, on Seclo Sounds. We are community radio for Milton Keynes. We're all about business and meeting and networking and growing the city, the economy in Milton Keynes. And a part of that is young talent and young people. And we have Debbie Glockelen from MK Academy with us today, and a student in the sixth form who's J.Y. Sharif. Good morning, folks.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Debbie, what's your role at MK Academy?
I'm the Director of Business, Enterprise and Employability, and it's my responsibility to create business links and community links to make sure that we're creating students who go on to their next step with the right skills and attitudes that employers and universities and colleges and apprenticeship providers require.
So why doesn't an academy just concentrate on learning teaching the curriculum?
Well, we know that it is vital for students to get the right qualifications and the highest possible degree
start in life.
Yes. Yeah. That's vital. That will get them the interview. Yeah. But what will get them the job and the future promotions are the actual attitudes and skills that they can show.
Yes.
So at the Academy, we are showing all students from year seven upwards what we call the big six. And the big six are employability skills that employers have told us they really value.
Yes. So what are those kind of employability skills?
Well, according to our friends in the business community, the things that they really value are teamwork, communication, problem solving, leadership skills, financial capability, and managing and organising.
Yes. So you've got an event coming up, haven't you, on the 26th, an early morning breakfast networking event.
A very early morning. And next Thursday, on the 26th, we've got a range of businesses and teachers and students who are having breakfast together. It starts at 7:30, which is the downside.
Yep.
The plus side is it's free.
Yes.
We've got a fantastic presentation from the director of MK Museum, Bill Griffiths.
Yeah.
We've also got some of our young people telling businesses actually what they've been up to, and a good networking opportunity.
Yes. So it's important for you to organise these events, and you've had them before, and no doubt you'll do them again.
Yes.
But have you found them a useful way of kind of finding out what the business community wants and generally networking?
Yes, it's been very helpful. We are very lucky. We have got some really good partners. But these business breakfast events give us a chance to actually show other businesses what it's possible to contribute to the Academy. It's our way of also saying thank you to the businesses who are involved with us. And it gives businesses a chance to talk to students and teachers about what's going on in school.
Yes. And has the kind of feedback that you've had from businesses led to anything in particular, that way that you...
It has done. We have at the Academy something called the Employability Charter. We have an employability steering group, and we have on the steering group a representative from a large company, the Halifax, medium Nifty Lift, and David Stimson, who's a sole trader.
Well known of this parish.
And very well known of this parish. And they, together with local universities, help us make sure that our curriculum is actually adapted and fit for 21st century employment later on in the students' lives.
Yeah. So how can you find out more details about the networking event?
Well, if you'd like to go to our MK Academy website, you'll find an invitation on there, or people are very, very welcome to email me. I'm not quite sure how we get the email address out, though.
You can read it across now if you
okay.
want.
Okay. Yep. I have a very strange name, so hold on here. It's D for Deborah, and then it's G-O-C-K-E-L-E-N at miltonkeynesacademy.co.uk. If you don't remember that, just go for info at Milton Keynes Academy, yes, and it will get to me.
Excellent. So are you expecting a good turnout next Thursday?
Yes, we're very pleased with the response. Yes, it does tend to be growing with each event.
Yes, because the word spreads, doesn't it?
It does.
Especially if the breakfasts are good.
The breakfasts are good and the breakfasts are free, which is a unique selling point.
Excellent. So over to JY now, I suppose. JY Shiv, you're in the sixth form, aren't you? And what's it like at the MK Academy? How do they sort of teach you about these employability skills?
Well, they actually put us into, you know, a lot of the business breakfasts. They invite us to attend and to speak with these business people and to present to them so they can see what kind of skills we have. And also there's loads of opportunities for like internships and work. Yeah. For example, some students in our school are working at the Halifax Bank. Uh-huh. And there's other opportunities like that. They also take us out on trips. For example, the Brett's Foundation, they have a training academy where they take students in and they teach them social etiquette, business skills, and interview skills to help them in their future jobs.
Yeah.
And I was lucky enough to go on that trip and I benefited a lot from it. They taught me how to present myself, how to speak in an interview, how to shake another person's hand, you know, look at them in the eye. These kind of skills that a lot of people are not necessarily taught when from school and from their parents at home.
Yeah, absolutely. So you'll be at the breakfast on Thursday, next Thursday, will you?
Yeah, I should be. I'm always there. Yeah.
What's it like getting up for a bit breakfast at 7 o'clock?
Well, it's free breakfast, so.
You'll be there, definitely.
Yeah, definitely.
You also took part in Young Enterprise, didn't you? The sort of business program.
Yeah, I did.
Are you doing it this year as well?
Oh, no, I'm not. Yeah. The year 12s are doing it this year.
Uh-huh. So, what was the project that you were involved in?
Well, Young Enterprise was a crazy roller coaster. So, we started off with designing a pillow, which had speakers inside it, and also you could change the heating on it. So, you know, in the summer, you know, them sweaty nights where you just flip the pillow over to get the cool side, it would cool down for you.
Oh,
and
right.
Also in the winter when it's really cold, you know, it would heat up and give you a nice warm pillow.
Yeah.
And that's where we started. But then obviously we had issues with, you know, safety and designing the thing. It cost quite a lot of money, so we had to shift to something else. And one of our designers made us a really nice logo. And from there we thought, how about we make children's toys and products to help children go to sleep at night, you know, little storybooks and things like that. And it just developed from there.
Did you call yourselves Pillow People?
Yes,
That's right. Yeah, I think I came across that. You think you had some coverage in the Citizen as well, didn't you?
The
local papers. Yeah, so brilliant. Thank you very much for coming in from MK Academy. Hope the networking goes well.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Along. And if I can make it, I'll bring along a microphone or something. I'm not sure I'm up to doing it, using a microphone before 7 o'clock in the morning, but there you go. Anyway, thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure, thanks.
Before we move on to Nicholas Mann from Interdirect and then to Kevin Hollick from Screenetics, who's involved in a charity event coming up, play a track called House of the Rising Sun by The Animals. So don't go away, listeners. Don't you dare go away.